Now that we have simulated this structure for a single wavelength, it's now time to simulate the whole structure for a range of wavelengths, and I'm talking about parametric sweep. For parametric sweep, you select, right click on the study one and select parametric sweep. You select first of all or add a variable for which you want to do parametric sweep, and in this case I am doing for lambda. You specify the range, I usually specify it in the number of values, and I want to see it for instance for 1.45 till 1.6, and let's divide it in 10 or 11 points for quick simulation. Do not forget to write the units, because it would just take it in meters. And next thing, what you do here, you just put your initial value as this one, around which it will search it more, since it's a numerical technique. So I'm going to copy this and provide this value as initial value to find mode around it. Simulation study, clear the previous solution and compute again. Let's see the results. In the line plot, I select parametric sweep and see the line of it, and you can see it found the right modes every time, and these are the modes. Let's see the constant value is a function of lambda. So it's with increasing wavelength, the propagation constant decreases. Now you can carry out the parametric sweep. Now, one thing about this mesh, still this mesh is too coarse and it won't give you the right results. So the much more memory you have or RAM you have, the more you can make your mesh finer by playing with these parameters like maximum element size and minimum element size and those things. You can do compartmentization in your area of interest and just increase mesh over there.